on in Year 10. This morning what we're looking at is the question as whether or not we need nuclear weapons for our security.
We started off the lesson by a continuum exercise just to get students the opportunity to think about where their opinions lie at the beginning of the lesson.
Right, you know what I'm going to ask you to do now, don't you? We're going to do a continuum. So if you strongly agree with disarmament, can you get out of your chairs and go and stand near Megan? And if you more favourable towards deterrence and keeping those weapons, somewhere along the line, please, Year 10.
It gives everybody opportunity to have their say and getting them to remember and just take a snapshot of where they were on that line. So when we revisit the line at the end of the lesson, we can see whether or not the lessons caused them to change their views.
Oh, David, you're standing there on your own. What a brave man this morning. Tell us why are you standing in that position?
If the world was without nuclear weapons, then there wouldn't be the threat of mass destruction of a city. But there's the factor of who's going to disarm first.
I was quite surprised that there were so many people still near having nuclear weapons as a deterrence. To me, that shows the maturity of some of the views that they were already thinking through. Well, what if we didn't have weapons?
Okay, what would happen if a British nuclear weapon was dropped on our school? So here we have the lovely Hessle High School on a nice sunny day. What would happen if a nuclear weapon was dropped on the school? Within 4 kilometres of the school, there would be complete destruction of the buildings. There would be fires and super infernos. And the winds would rage at 1,000 miles per hour. People close to the centre of the blast would be reduced to shadows.
I knew that they caused destruction, but I didn't really know on what scale, and now I know what scale it is, which has reinforced my opinion.
The exposed skin would burn from heat rays, and lots of radiation would be released, causing sickness.
I thought the statistics were really scary and horrible, the fact that someone can do that to so many people, the fact that it can kill citizens who haven't done anything wrong, when it's just the government.
Okay, the nuclear quiz. We're just going to have a short quiz just to check our knowledge about nuclear weapons and countries who hold them.
A quick quiz at the beginning of a lesson is really good for myth busting. It gets students straight away to focus. There's always that element of competition that they want to try and get more answers right than the other teams.
What's the name of the Britain's nuclear weapons system? A, Orbit. B, Hubba Bubba. Well done, Joe. C, Airwaves. Anyone else already got it? D, Trident. Okay, that's Trident.
The bomb factor lesson is trying to ask the question, are nuclear weapons needed, necessary for security?
Does anybody here like the X Factor? So, what we're going to do, our activity, is we're going to examine some different views. You're going to be given, in groups, different opinions. If it's a tick, it will show you that you are for nuclear weapons. If it's a cross, then it's showing you that you're not. And in an X Factor creative style, let's have a look at how we can use some of these arguments to show that Hessle High School's got talent.
Each group is given a piece of information about either an organisation that's for or against nuclear weapons or a country. And it gives just a few pieces of information to the students about that country.
Oh, could you, if you do a play thing, from the perspective of someone that's being affected by it.
How are you doing, girls?
We're doing a news report.
A news report?
Yeah. Okay. We're going to have Megan has like the government for nuclear weapons, saying how good it is, and then she's going to be arguing with Abby, who's against nuclear weapons, who's going to be a protester outside the factory, and then I'm going to be reporting like what's going on between them.
Brilliant. So you've got a bit of protest going on as well.
But then overall, Megan's going to overrule because we're like for nuclear weapons.
We're not
going to
be like nuclear bomb that bad.
Lots of information.
I'm the protester, and I'm just going to basically hold up a sign and argue with Megan. If it came to it, and I was old enough, and there was like a big argument, I know there is an argument over it now, but like a huge one, I'd most probably want to protest against it rather than before it.
The other good side of it, which makes it sort of the bomb factor thing, is that you have three judges. The judges are given the lead for the task. They decide how they're going to mark and what marks they're going to give for each performance of the different countries or organisations.
No, it's not ICAN, it's not ICAN.
No, what's that? ICAN.
It's the anti-nuclear thing.
Oh, right, okay.
Association, I'm taking it.
And then what else is there? There's humour.
Information.
And
then originality.
And then we need to come up with some phrases that we can say at the end of that act. So they always seem to have phrases.
You blew me away.
The impasse that now exists regarding the international control of atomic energy must be broken, and the Assembly must face this question squarely for the sake of mankind and for the peace of the world.
The world has been aroused. The choice is ours. We must not fail.
If students can have choice within what they're doing, then that gives them that power. It gives them the opportunity to have a voice. It gives them the opportunity to represent and show their views.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the final of Hessle High's The Bomb Factor. Now for our first act. Can we please have the USA?
Okay, we are going to sing a song to the tune of Magical Trevor called Magical America, about America's nukes, which we hope shares our beliefs.
Ours are America, which was four nukes, and me and my friend made up a song about America's opinions and then summarised at the end.
We as America, being the first country ever to develop nukes and use them, believe that it is our right to protect the world using nukes. And because of this, we think that our friends should disarm whilst we protect them and keep an eye over countries like Russia and Iran whilst trying to persuade them to disarm.
But surely if you think that your weapons could destroy the whole world, then why would you use them?
Because we wouldn't use them all at once.
Thank you very much. I was one of the judges in The Bomb Factor. It was good, actually. It meant that I could see what other people could come up with, and it was interesting to see what people thought.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, put your heads together for our host. Hello, hello, and welcome to the most rubbish game show in the world ever.
It certainly is.
Right, first question. What is the temperature when a nuke explodes at ground level?
Really, really hot.
Well, that's correct, but we were looking for something a bit more specific. It's actually 6,000 degrees.
Over the course of the lesson, I learned some of the statistics about the amount of nuclear weapons there are, and it was quite... because I had no idea that there was that many and how much they cost.
I take it you're going for the comedy approach.
No, not at all.
No. Where'd you get that idea from?
Personally, what are your opinions on nuclear war?
That we should just get rid of all nuclear weapons because it doesn't really help anyone and it ends up with people dying and unnecessary deaths.
think using humour and trying to present really serious issues in a way that's that little bit creative actually gets people to really think about the issues.
Okay, and now for our final act, the AWE.
Good evening and welcome to BBC News at 6. I'm Lucy Baker and I'm reporting for BBC News. We're at the NWE to show you today Mrs. Future Prime Minister Anne Abbey, who showed that nuclear weapons are bad and nuclear weapons are apparently good. Tell us what you think about that.
I think nuclear weapons are absolutely disgusting and I'm ashamed that this country, that all the countries that have them make them.
I think that they are good. We need them to defend our country against other countries with nuclear weapons.
We decided to do a news piece so that we could have both sides of the argument, but because our fact thing was actually for nuclear weapons, we had to have, in the end, the nuclear weapons winning.
Stop nuclear war!
And then Abby feels like quite strongly for not having nuclear weapons, and Megan was a bit like not really knowing, and I was sort of in the middle of them both, so that's why we chose to do those roles in it.
And there you have it, nothing to say.
A controversial subject in citizenship can really get the students' opinions going, and you're teaching them the skills that of citizenship, so they can begin to practice their having their own voice and opinion. They can practice being persuasive.
We have in joint second with scores of 102, Japan and AWE, which means
with a score of 105, USA are the winners.
Right, Year 10, well done. You've proved that Hessle High School has got talent and we've done our bomb factor. To finish it off though, what we want to do is a phone vote. And the way we're going to do this is if you can put your heads down so it's anonymous. So the first question then, do we need them for our security? If you think yes, we do need them for our security, can you raise your...
I still believe that they need us as a deterrent, because after seeing just how powerful they are, it shows just how bad it can be if a country is hit with a nuclear weapon and they don't have anything to strike back with.
I didn't really know much about them and thought there was not really much point to them at all, but as the lesson went on, I thought we should have them for, like, security, but I don't think they should ever be used.
In my opinion, I don't think they should, because if you don't have nuclear weapons, then you don't have the threat, which means that you don't have to worry about other countries, which means there would be no nuclear war.